all the important words in a short way. So use shorthand. And lastly, you should summarize in your own words. So whatever you're hearing maybe from me or anybody else, you need to summarize that in your own words and not just try to write out everything that I'm saying. That is the second stage, which is taking notes. What is note making?
Good.
What is note making? Okay, so note making is a process where you try to make notes out of your short notes. So you make notes. So if you are writing on a paper now, when you go home, you take that paper and write in a book. So you're now trying to make meaning of the notes that you wrote in class using your own words. So you need to review the notes, you need to write down the main ideas. And also review the notes. So note making helps you to understand and keep the things in your head. You can also correct the spellings of the things you were writing in case the spelling was wrong, and add more things that make sense. So that is not me. What is the meaning of verbal skills? That's the point. You are the point, not the only person. The meaning of verbal skills?
Verbal skills are skills that are used when. That I use when someone is trying to interpretate in a verbal form.
The verbal form is which one?
By using the verbal form.
Okay, so. So. The skills is for communication. Which type of communication? Okay, so this is the use of words to share ideas. So I don't think we can actually call it mouth to mouth, but we use your mouth. So this is also called speaking. That is incredible communication. So for you to communicate face to face using words, you also need to practice a lot. You need to know what type of words you can use and also your audience. Think about them. Verbal communication or verbal skills. Verbal. No? Connection. So, the verbal skills involve the choice of words. It also involves how you say them. It involves how you make meaning of those things. And when using verbal skills or verbal communication, you also need to be mindful of nonverbal communication. That one comes when you are interacting with people face to face. So be mindful of nonverbal. Communication. So when we look at speaking skills, there are things that you need to know. So the first is fluency. And there is vocabulary, there is grammar and pronunciation.
I'm not a person. know?
Okay, so it is how confident and comfortable the speaker is when speaking English.
Yeah, you can write that.
Okay. So she also said it includes the speech you take when speaking English.
Oh,
if you can speak fast enough and be able to mix the words properly, that is called fluent. Okay, so speaking in an extended period of time is an indicator of fluency. Approach. What kind of approach? Explain it.
When telling someone to perform a speed and how to speak of his grammar, can this be the approach of the best one? Yeah.
It is shown through making a clear connection. Between words and ideas. So you can try maybe on your own to speak in English, try to record yourself in order to be fluent. You can try to prepare yourself for presentations by recording yourself and trying to explain the things that you want to present without copying. When we are also looking at speaking skills, the other is vocabulary.
Or no mistakes at all.
about grammar. So you need to know the difference between the singular and the plural. Know how to link your words to the things you are saying. Look for punctuation in your words. So do not speak too fast so that your audience cannot miss what you are saying. So without proper grammar, everything can be confusing. So you can try to listen to yourself when you're speaking so you do not make mistakes. Speaking skills. The first is
Reinforcement, like, okay, let's give an example. Somebody has given a correct answer. If you can say, clappers for him, clappers for her, if I take the money, will give it to him or her, that's reinforcement.
Okay, any other idea of what that could be in relation to speaking to you? How do you take responsibility? How do you take charge? Okay, so this is using encouraging words alongside your nonverbal gifts. So you can try to speak with a smile on your face, maintaining eye contact when speaking. That is reinforcement. So this can encourage others to participate. Benya, what is the importance of reinforcement? So it also shows interest in what others have to say. It helps you to maintain and also build relationships. It also reduces the shyness. Why is it important? it is important to use open-ended questions. And questioning. Also a way that conversation. So reflecting involves repeating what the other person has said, but in your own words. So it can be used to check if you have actually understood the message clearly, and it also gives the speaker feedback. And it shows that you are interested in the message.
Thank you. I'm going to take a Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.